Hey everyone, this is Stephen Strawn at Cast Iron Cookware, where you can find information to help you better collect, restore, and use cast iron cookware. Today we're going to be doing a demonstration on how to put together a lye tank, and we're going to be doing a small version of it in this 5-gallon bucket, and we're going to be doing that coming right up. Before we go any further, I just want to say thank you to everyone that has purchased my product. Beezy Beezy Cast Iron Seasoning is a product that I developed, and it comes in this nice little handy tube that really looks good sitting on your counter, and it's easy to open. And I went ahead and changed the packaging somewhat to a black and white or grayscale as opposed to the color. It's a blend of beeswax, grapeseed oil, and avocado oil, all wrapped up in a nice convenient stick. Thus the reason why I gave it the name Easy Beezy, because it's so easy peasy. So check it out. You can find it at cicookware.com. And I just want to say the purchase of this product goes a long ways in keeping this channel going, and I appreciate it so very much. Okay, just like I said earlier, we're going to be doing a lye tank demonstration. Me personally, I believe that there's only two actually safe ways to strip cast iron cookware. One is the use of electrolysis, which involves a little bit of engineering, which is not too difficult. Most people can do it. And the other is a lye tank, which is really simple. There's another version, which is the modification of a lye tank, which is the easy off oven spray in a bag method. Today we're going to be talking about setting up a lye tank. Now let me back the camera up so you can kind of get a wider view of what's going on. Okay, what we have here is a 5-gallon bucket, and I've got the lid, and I believe I purchased this at Walmart just a little bit earlier for like a dollar and something. I'm not sure exactly how much. I think $1.50, give or take a little bit. And I got this lye, which is 100% lye. Now when you do this, get 100%, and that's what we have, 100% lye. I picked this up at Ace Hardware. But you can also get it on Amazon, this exact type. I'll leave a link in the description below if you want to check it out. It is 100% lye, and it's called drain cleaner. We're going to use 1 pound per 5 gallons. That is the ratio. So we have a 5-gallon bucket, and I have 1 pound. I'm going to do this demonstration inside my studio. Now, you would probably rather do it outside. Okay, there's 3 things we're going to need. Number one, we're going to need some protective safety glasses or goggles, just in case you splash any in your eyes. You also need some rubber gloves of some kind. You can use rubber gloves, or you can also use some oven mitts like this that are made out of neoprene or rubber. I'm gonna go ahead and use my grill armor gloves. Oh, there's another safety feature as well. I like to keep a spray bottle of 50% water, 50% vinegar. And what that does, you have the ability to neutralize lye. So if you get a little bit on your arm or your hand, you can kind of give yourself a spritz. It will neutralize it and you're good. And then you can just go wash with soap and water, and you're not going to burn yourself or have any issues. Now the biggest pan that I'm going to use is a number 7. I've got this beautiful number 9 Red Mountain skillet that needs to be done, and it will not fit inside my 5-gallon bucket. Even if you could cram it down in there, the handle's not going to fit. So in that case, you need something a little bit larger, like this big tub here, and it's going to be more than 5 gallons. Now something like that will work out just right for a larger pan. But I can tell you, a number 8 skillet or a number 9 will not fit in a 5-gallon bucket and still be able to put the lid on it. You might be able to squeeze a number 8 down in there, but your handle is going to stick out of the water. And if you want the entire thing stripped, you want the entire piece of cast iron submerged underneath your lye bath water. This here is actually a 10-gallon foot tub. So with that ratio, if you were going to fill this up, you will need 2 of these 1-pound containers of lye. So let's move this aside since we're not going to be using a big tank today. There is a way that you want to mix these ingredients up. You don't pour your lye in first and then you water. You go ahead and fill your bucket up full of water first. Then we add our lye. So let's get this filled up and I'll bring it back in here. Okay, we have our 5 gallon bucket full of water. Now, I did not put 5 gallons in it because there's going to be some displacement from the pans, but I want to make sure that they're going to be covered. So after I get everything mixed up and then I put my pans in there, then I may top it off a little just to make sure everything is underwater. But you don't want to put your lye in first and then add water. You want to start off with water and then add your lye. And it's going to be in granule form, just going to look a lot like salt. And I'm going to take my time. And we're going to put the entire 1 pound bottle in there. Also, we're going to take a disposable stick. This is like a paint stir stick. And we're going to take our time, don't splash. Just take your time, swirl it around, and you can hear the lye spinning around on the bottom. Now, you will have some fumes. It's best to do this outside, but for the video purposes, for me, I'm doing it inside. A vent fan would be great. It's not too awfully bad. And I don't hear the granules anymore. So I'm gonna find a way to dispose of this. I'm just gonna throw this in the trash. Okay, so we're gonna start off with this little unmarked Wagner. Now, you wanna be careful and not splash yourself. And I also have a number 7 three-notch lodge with a blob. And it's gonna slide right down in here as well. And then I have a number 7 National that needs a little bit of stripping. It's going to slide right in there. And I've already dry fit these things. And then we have a little Wagner wire skillet that's got a little bit of corrosion that needs a little bit of tender love and care. And last but not least is this really corroded pan. I'll try to zoom in on it. This is a little number 5 Birmingham stove and range, and you can see the crud. This is going to be the one that will have the most to take off. I didn't really show you the other pieces, but this one you needed to see so we can see the difference. We don't have it completely underwater, so I'm going to go ahead and get some more water and pour in this just to kind of add to it. And now we can go ahead and top it off. Just be careful not to splash. Now if you're outside, it's not gonna matter as much, but we're inside. And you can already see it's starting to work. So we're gonna cover this up. Okay. And we didn't get a single drop on our gloves, which is nice. Okay, now that we got our lid on our little 5 gallon bucket, right now inside my home, it's about 72, 73 degrees. So it's going to go pretty good. I'm going to give it 4 days, maybe 3, but I'm just not going to look at it, not going to touch it, not going to do anything for 3 days. We can leave it a week. We can leave it a month. I've known people that has put a piece in a lye tank and forgot about it for like a year and went back. It's not going to harm it whatsoever, as long as it's not made out of aluminum. Now, if it's made out of aluminum, it will totally disintegrate it. Not to mention that, it will produce a gas that is highly flammable and not good for you at all. So do not put aluminum in your lye tank at all. That's the beauty of the lye tank. So we'll come back in 3 days and we'll see what kind of progress we're having. Okay, we've got our bucket and we've had 3 days since we put them in. And we're gonna go ahead and open this bucket up and take a look at them. We're inside my house, inside my studio. I would suggest if you're going to do this, do it outside. That way you can take a garden hose. Now, I'm going to have to transfer each individual one to the sink, but we're going to take them out, and we've got some cardboard here. We're going to lay them out and just see what kind of progress we've got. So don't forget our safety glasses. Also, I have my grill armor, moisture resistant gloves, but let's pull our camera down so we can see what we're doing. We also don't want to forget our little handy dandy vinegar water solution as a spray, just in case we need it. Got it handy. So we're going to go really easy because I have got this one pretty full. And I'm going to open it on the farther side. So if there's a splash, it's going to go that direction. Okay, if you notice, our water is really, really black and we can't see anything. So we're going to need some kind of a fish hook. Okay, I have a metal coat hanger and I'm just going to stretch this out. And there I go, I got my fish hook. See which side the handles are on. Oh, here we go. And this is a lot like fishing. I caught one. So, I'm going to drain as much off as possible. Looks like I caught a number 5 BSR. Two and one. Two on the same hook. Looks like I caught a Wagner. Now this is a nice one. Looks like we caught a National. And here we go, looks like we got a 3-notch lodge here. I can't remember how many I put in here, so. See if there's any more fish in the bucket. Oh, I hear some metal. I forgot about this little guy. It's our unmarked Wagner muffin pan. And that is all we have. Let's pull a camera down and take a look. I suppose the one that had the best results is going to be her little Wagner muffin pan. And it's going to clean completely up. We're going to set this on the side. We'll rinse it off. And her little Wagner where it might need to go back in. We're going to rinse it off, give it a little bit of a scrub. It looks like it's pretty loose. So we're going to stack these up. We're going to carry them to the sink. And work on them. After we get these rinsed off and maybe scrub them a little bit, we'll bring them back in here and take a look at them, see if they need to go back in the tank for a day or two. So we'll be right back. Okay, I've got some of these out. And what I like to do, I'll dry it really quickly and give it a spritz. So grapeseed oil and avocado oil in my blend. And then dry it off the rest of the way with a paper towel. There's one down. And I've already sprayed this one with my grapeseed oil. If you see any spots, it's trying to show a little bit of rust. Just rub it in and that'll avoid your flash rust right there. Main thing is we want to avoid flash rust. They were still a little bit wet. And we can see we're starting to get a little bit of rust trying to sneak up on us right here. That's why I like the spray. And then you take your fingers and kind of work it in. Then when you know that you have coverage of oil everywhere and most of your water is displaced, we can start wiping off the excess. Then we'll take a look at this little unmarked Wagner muffin pan. Now it's still dripping with oil, but it come clean. Now there are a few stains on it that won't come off with lye or probably anything else. So we're just gonna season right over that. Let's take a look at our little one notch lodge with a blob. So number 7, it's got a little blob here. It's hard to tell with all the wool. Now it's got a really nice, slick cooking surface. We'll put all these in the oven that we're not gonna put back in the lye tank. And what we'll do is we'll heat them up to about maybe 300 degrees. We'll get them back out and we'll wipe them down as good as we possibly can, because there's still going to be a microscopic level of oil on the pan. You don't see it, but it's there. And that's what you want. That gets you your best layers of seasoning. Now this little National, I think it is going to turn out good. It's a National number 7. Now there's staining, and you can see there's some staining involved. You look at the handle there. And there's some staining on the inside. But the surface is really smooth. There's no utensil marks or anything like that. And it is really light. That's a nice piece right there. Let's take our little Birmingham stove and range, number 5. Try to dry it as much as possible where we can get a good look at it without it being so shiny. Ain't that a nice surface right there? Of course, our little telltale ridge, and this one right here is labeled 5B. It's a Red Mountain, number 5. The B is the mold mark, and it's going to be a pretty one. And last but not least, this little Wagner, and it has seen a rough lifetime. Let's get a little oil on that baby. I see a little bit of flash rust trying to grab it. The inside of this one is just rough and pitted, but all the old seasoning came off. It's rough. Of course, it's a Wagner wire, marked Wagner wire. And it's got some staining and some pitting. Just a lot going on. Just for curiosity's sake, I won't stick this one back in the lye tank. It looks like it could use a little more. So I'm gonna put it back in the lye tank along with this little number 7. It's been in the lye tank and it's got a little bit of seasoning that never turned loose right there. This one is going to a friend of mine in Canada. So I want to get it looking good. So I'm going to drop it and this little number 5 Wagner back in the lye tank. Okay, yeah. We got 4 pieces that come out looking good. One that maybe need a little more work just because it looks so bad. I'm going to give it a couple more days and I'll get it out later and check it out. But in the meantime, we're going to go ahead and season up these 4 pieces that I have. This little Wagner unmarked, the National, the 3 Notch Lodge, and the number 5 BSR Red Mountain. But the concept I was trying to share with you is possible to do a lye tank in a 5-gallon bucket or a foot tub or something small. You don't need a big area. It's probably better to keep it outside. That way you can rinse it with a garden hose. And don't forget, you can also spray it down with vinegar water and neutralize the lye. But it's just so much easier if you're outside and you have a garden hose, just let it go. The more water you pour to it, the more it gets diluted and the less activity you have till there's no activity at all. Scrub them down with a scrubby, soap and water, an SOS pad, or a chain mail. And once you get it all done, you can just start the seasoning process. But I hope that you've enjoyed this video, and if you have, please don't forget to subscribe, hit the notification bell, and I promise I'll keep more of them coming. You can also follow Cast Iron Cookware on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Check out my website, cicookware.com. You can sign up to receive emails from Cast Iron Cookware. I try to send one out about once a month. Check out the Cast Iron Cookware Facebook group. It is really, really growing. And I just want to say thank you again for watching Cast Iron Cookware. Before you go, I just want to share something with you really quickly. In Matthew chapter 5, verse 14 through 16, it says, "You are the light of the world. A city that is set on an hill cannot be hid. Neither do men light a candle and put it under a bushel, but on a candlestick, and it giveth light unto all that are in the house. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven." I just want to say, share the word and be a blessing.